What's happening YouTube? Commander JSP here. I've been ripping a lot of this 2011 Topps Heritage baseball product, and I've been watching you all rip a lot of it. First off, thanks for sharing your videos with me. I not only like to post videos, but I also enjoy watching y'all's rips too. But there seems to be a lot of confusion, and rightly so, on the SP variants on this set, because there are a lot of them. They're different. And a lot of people are assuming this is an SP. Well, no, a lot of times they're wrong. And I don't know them all either. I mean, until a list comes out and stipulates every single variant, if that ever happens, we won't really know. But I'll go over some that I'm certain are SPs, and I'll show you the subtle differences. Okay? Of course, up here on the top, we'll start with Phil Hughes. Now, this here is a black border SP card that comes in a blister pack from Target. You get three packs of Heritage and then three of these cards in a clear cello. This is a stipulated a C prefix followed by a number. So this is its own little subset, but it is a short print subset. So it's an SP, but it's not the true SP variant that everybody seems to have trouble with. This one's pretty dang easy to identify by the front and the back. Of course, these New Age Performers, they're also SPs, but they're not variant SPs. They're just SPs as far as I know. I've never seen a tint or a colored one, but everybody seems to be able to determine that, hey, these are SPs because they're their own little subset. Same thing with this here, Then and Now. This one's a Mickey Mantle and Prince Fielder. It's numbered TN5. We know it's a subset, and it's a short print subset. That would be a nice one to get the patch card on, that's for sure. Okay, then this one here, Jackie Robinson. This is not the Jackie Robinson ultra rare short print subset. That one kind of mirrors the Babe Ruth story subset. This here is just a Newsflash SP numbered NF10, and it happens to be of Jackie Robinson getting enshrined in Cooperstown back in 1962. So this one's pretty easy to identify too. There's, you know, several different cards. You have Mona Lisa's in this set. Everybody's familiar with that one. This is also, as far as I know, an SP. It's in very short supply, I know that. The Sporting News cards. They're in the high 300s, I think low 4s. I notice a lot of you, you know, when you look at your cards, you're turning it over to look at the back like you can tell it's an SP by the back. Just because it has a high number, I don't think that determines it's a total SP. It certainly is an SP variant, and the SP variants are what are hot, and that's what everybody wants. And we'll start out looking at all four that I'm aware of. There might be more. I mean, I don't know. This is a crazy set. It always has been. But we'll start out here, and let me see. I'm going to take the camera off the tripod so that I can actually do some close-ups for y'all. All right, this here is the green tint. Okay, I know it's an SP because I have the regular issue card and then I have this green card. Some cards have green grass behind them and can confuse you. Some have blue sky behind you and you can think, or behind the player, and you can think, hey, that's an SP. Well, not always. The best way to tell an SP is to get both of them, then you know it's an SP. This right here is the green of Alex Rios. It came from Target. And when you look at the back, I mean, I can't see any big difference there. I mean, y'all tell me if there is. The cardboard may be a little different colored. I mean, a little darker on this regular issue than the SP, but I've seen it go both ways on that. The numbers are the same. There's no little asterisk or anything. No difference at all. Not even in the small fine print. So I don't know what would stipulate this as an SP versus a regular by looking at the back. That's what makes it so difficult to figure out. Okay, so this was the green one. We'll take one last look at that. Then this is the Walmart SP, the blue. Okay, this one's of Joe Pinero. And it's obvious that there's a big difference here. That's not sky, that's just blue. Once again, you turn it over, I don't see a difference on the back. So I don't know that looking at the back's gonna aid you other than telling you, hey, this card's card number 392. I mean, great, we know that. All right, now here is an SP down here of Mark Scatero. This is, I guess, a tint. It's almost like a, I don't know, it's almost like a Technicolor tint or something. I don't know what I'd call that, but this is also an SP. I believe this came from Walmart. I'm not 100% sure. I think it did. I wasn't paying attention, and I noticed it when I was collating the cards into my set. Once again, the back, can't tell. So you notice there's just a difference in the color. This color here looks a little, I don't know, it's a little more natural than this one. This one looks kind of like the contrast has been cranked up on it or something on Photoshop. But, you know, that's something you're going to have both cards once again to tell, because some of the other cards in the set that aren't the SP tint kind of are Photoshopped to the max, and you know, the color of the card overall has been influenced. All right, here is the red Target SP. Very hard to get also. I've got a couple of these greens, but this and a couple of the blues, and this red seems to be the only one I have. So I believe that that's the SP. I believe that's the regular card. I don't know because I don't have the regular card in a duplicate form yet. But I'm going to go out on a limb and say this is the red SP. You can see it's of Miguel Tejada. Once again, on the back, I couldn't see any differences in anything. So I guess the best way to tell an SP is to have the regular issue and the SP together side by side like I've got them here. And then you can determine, well, this is obviously an SP. Well, guys, good luck. Keep buying those packs. Keep sharing your rips. And any knowledge you gain, if I've made any comments or statements that aren't, you know, factual, let me know about it. Don't be afraid. Don't sugarcoat it. Just tell me, hey, dude, that isn't a red, or hey, dude, that isn't a whatever. You know, we can discuss it. I want to learn. I want to figure out what I'm buying here and pursue the ones that I want. And that's what card collecting is all about. So keep watching. Thanks for watching. I hope this has helped some of y'all. And stay thirsty, my friends. SP.